Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to be answering all of your questions. I had put out a post on Instagram and on Snapchat. I enjoy doing Q&A type videos because I love to chat and I love to talk and you guys have questions, so let's get to answering. So what are your favorite shows to binge on Hulu or Netflix? That's easy. Game of Thrones, Mad Men, Shameless, Silicon Valley on HBO. I know that's not on Hulu or Netflix. And if you want to watch somebody that looks so hot, then you need to watch Sons of Anarchy because I'm not into motorcycles, but I am now. Next question is, what's a good red wine for a white wine lover? I want to cross to the dark side. Yeah, you do. You definitely do. Off the top of my head, have you tried Apothic Red and La Storia Zinfandel? Zinfandels are really lovely if you're normally a white wine drinker because they're typically a little bit sweeter, but not too sweet. Pick yourself up a Zinfandel. Definitely try the La Storia because it's divine. What state has been your favorite to live in so far? So for those of you who aren't familiar, I'm a military wife. We have lived in three states within the past year and a half or so. I've lived in New Jersey. I was born and raised in Wisconsin, first of all. I did live in Minnesota for just a little bit. Colorado, Mississippi, and now Texas. Every state has its pros and cons, but I would definitely say overall as a whole, I probably loved Colorado the most for obvious reasons. It's gorgeous. The winters are pretty mild. The summers are amazing. They do not have humidity. However, I kind of missed trees living there because it's a little bit drier of a climate, so there's not those pretty leafy trees that you get up north in the fall, which is my favorite season, and I love to see the transition of the leaves and stuff, and I loved that about New Jersey. And so I liked living in Jersey though too, but see, it's hard because we were going through like I had babies in Jersey, so I really didn't get to do as much as I could now with older children. And so if I were living in Jersey now, I would have definitely had date night in New York City. There's just things like that I would have loved to do. Seen a show on Broadway, go and just go out to eat in New York City, for goodness sake. But I really enjoyed Colorado as a whole. It's a great family state to live in. Lots of outdoorsy type things, and they take their dogs everywhere. Seriously, there are dog bowls outside of Sephora in Colorado. Next question is kind of related to that. Will your family continue to move every year? We're hoping that we'll be here for a solid 4 years. It's supposed to be like a 4-year tour. We will see because things can change like that. And so I don't know. There's a lot of unknowns with this new position that my husband has taken. So it's just basically a lot of unknowns. How many tattoos do you have? I currently have 7 tattoos. So this is the most recent one that I got. And as you can see, it is the word beautiful. I wanted to get that. I love script. I love the free-flowing, just delicate, wispy, feminine thing side of it. I guess if I had to describe me and, like my taste and stuff, that I would use those words. I wanted to get something to serve as a reminder for myself, but not only for me when I look at it, but for other people to know that you are beautiful and that you don't have to try to be somebody that you're not, that you may not have perfect hair or a perfect body. There's no such thing anyways, but as a woman, and I'm sure you understand, we can fall into that trap of comparing ourselves to other people, but everyone is beautiful and unique, and it's not a really deep situation, but it definitely for me serves as a reminder that Chelsea, you are beautiful. Who you are created to be is amazing. Be who you were created to be because nobody else can do you like you can do you. And so I just honestly really liked the script and I liked the placement of it. I just thought it was kind of cool. So there's that. The next question is, what's your workout schedule? I attend a gym. I had never gone to a gym prior to last year or so. My husband surprised me on his deployment and signed me up for a gym. I'm like, what are you saying? Like I need to be going to the gym. But it was actually a really sincere move to try to get me to get out of the house, drop the kids off at their little daycare section or whatever so I could work out and have some me time. And I didn't always work out. I would sometimes just go there and just relax and go to the coffee shop or eat lunch kind of thing. And so anyways, so I kind of got used to that. Then when we moved last year, there was just no time. We weren't in a location where they had a good gym. And then Chloe was starting school. Last year was really hectic, long story short. So this past winter when my husband was gone for work, I decided to, on a whim one day, join back up at a gym. So now I go to a gym and I go about 3 times a week. Right now I'm doing, it's called Alpha, but it's kind of like basically a type of CrossFit training. So it's a lot of heavy weights. I do that 3 times a week. A little bit of cardio, death by burpees, or running and lifting. And so I love it. I absolutely love it. I've seen more changes in my body since lifting weights than any cardio ever did for me. I've seen huge changes in my physique with lifting weights. What are your easy, healthy recipes? We do a lot of tacos. We buy a lot of ground turkey. I sometimes do ground beef, like if we want to do burgers on the grill and stuff. But for the most part, we do turkey, chicken, and some fish. My husband's not a huge fish lover, but most recently my daughter's fell in love with salmon. And so that's what I've been buying. Tacos, those are so easy to throw together. And you can, you know, make a salad out of it. You can make a wrap out of it. You can, I mean, there's endless toppings you can put on it. Another really, really simple recipe, and I actually just did it this past week. Crock pot, 2 cups of chicken stock, and then I usually do like 3 or 4 chicken breasts and then put it on low and let it cook all day. I love crock pot recipes. I make a lot of soup. I love chicken noodle soup. I love chicken tortilla soup, split pea soup. And I've actually, I'll link below the vlog where I made pea soup. It's really simple. And I actually vlogged me doing it. Another side note, are you guys interested in like cooking, like me vlogging, cooking in the kitchen, just chatting with you? Because I can definitely start doing, I can just start doing a whole lot more when my kids are in school. Right now, they're actually taking a nap, even though they fought me on it. And I use the time to like curl my hair, shower, put on makeup, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I have time to film a video. But that's basically been the reason why this summer's been kind of slacking on content. What is your favorite makeup brand? Oh, that is tough. I really like Laura Mercier. I love everything I've tried from Laura Mercier has not let me down, so I just think it's a beautiful brand, and I love that it's a little bit more, like, attainable type makeup. It's not, like, scary, like, you know how some brands are just, like for instance, Urban Decay. That's a much more edgier, I feel like, younger-focused brand. I think Laura Mercier is a beautiful brand. Charlotte Tilbury makes beautiful products. Tarte, really like Tarte. Smashbox, I think they're another underdog. They make some really great products. Are you having any more kids? No. No. I told my husband, if you were not in the military and maybe you were, I could guarantee that you're going to be home all the time, maybe I would have had another one. But after that first long deployment, I was like, nope, mama is set. How do you keep it all together in a new city when your husband is deployed? I have a routine. I actually have a video I made a few years ago during the second longer deployment, and I will link it below for any of you who are experienced in deployment right now, you're new to it, or you're just curious about some of my tips and tricks. But actually, I totally addressed this topic, and I'll link it. But basically, have a routine. Keep time for yourself. Work out. It is a great stress reliever to go to the gym and put, like, channel it into your workout, channel into those squats, because then your butt is going to thank you, your jeans are going to thank you, you know, and have movie nights, have nights where you eat 16 cookies in a row, like, just have a schedule, but then also break that schedule, be spontaneous, get out of your house, like, take walks. If you don't like to be around a lot of people, take walks, like, go to parks. But at the same time, get yourself involved. Have one good friend. And you're like, hey, Chelsea, I don't have a friend. Well, make one. Make one. Make friends with the checkout lady at Target. Go to her checkout every single time and just small chat. Stuff like that. You'd be surprised how it really can lift your spirits and just make you feel like you're not going insane and you're going to make it through. Holy Grail Foundation. I would have to say, off the top of my head, it's been in my favorites the past 2 years as far as my yearly favorites is concerned, and I'll have a separate review on it if you want to get into that, but it is the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Foundation, and I love that foundation for every single day. I think for photos, I would go for something a little bit fuller coverage, but on a daily use, I love it because, number one, my husband doesn't tell me I have cake face. I hate that. I hate when you put on a full face of makeup, and then you go outside, and you look at someone within, you know, like a talking distance, and they just look at your face weird, or he will straight up tell me if I have cake face, and I don't think that that is a good thing, because then I'd rather, like, not wear the makeup at all. It blends easy, it lasts nicely, so I would say that for sure. If you're not into a lighter coverage, today I'm wearing the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and I really like this foundation for a fuller coverage. I feel like it's has a really it has a blurring ability. Like, it's fuller coverage, it covers up the pores, but it doesn't ever look dry and cakey and just like makeup. I don't like foundations that look like makeup, you know. I used to, but now I don't. Seriously, cannot believe my kids are still napping. Fellow military wifey, oh, hello Annie. She says she would like to know how, ideal with military life, what you've learned from it, and how you keep the love alive while Hubs is away or deployed. So I've kind of addressed the other two things, and I will link that video for you in case you're interested. I would say I will address keeping the love alive. Let's just say that having an expensive camera has its perks when your husband is halfway across the world. Have you always been fit and healthy? I'm 40, about 50 pounds overweight. I know in my soul I'm ready not just to be skinny, but to be healthy. Don't chase the skinny, don't chase the number, just chase balance. That's my biggest thing I can share is balance. I've always struggled with like being in everything that I do, like super, super into it and I'm just full guns, or I'm not doing it at all. I'm gonna eat the entire package of Oreos. I did yesterday, or I'm not gonna eat it at all. And so it's that balance, and that's all it really is. It's like eat the cookie, buy the shoes, take the walk, take the run, you know, maybe have a day where you just do nothing. Like, just don't overthink it. Don't just become obsessed and consumed with it. Do something that works for your lifestyle. Cut out the pop, that kind of thing can, you know, the extra sugar is, I mean, if your body doesn't need the sugar, if your body doesn't use it, it straight up stores it. Those storage buildings that you see, like when you eat too much sugar, your body just basically rents out one of those units and stores it in there for later. I've always done sports. I did sports in high school. I did cross country and basketball and softball for a little bit. And I've always been into like riding my bike or running, doing yoga, Pilates. I've just kind of dabbled in all kinds of things. But I would say most recently, it's just been the weights, and I really enjoy it. I think there's something really invigorating and challenging. Oh my gosh, challenging about it. And it's not even about working harder, it's about working smarter. Like, your body's made in the kitchen, and that's another thing that I learned. I always thought if I ate McDonald's or Dairy Queen, now I have to go and run 16 miles tomorrow. Actually, that's not how it works. That's actually very damaging for your body. It's just everything in balance. And you know, if you live in a balanced life, you can have those cheat meals and cheat days, and it actually really doesn't make a difference in your body. So I don't know. I would just encourage you to just maybe start small. It's the small changes over the course of a long period of time that make the difference. What do you eat most days? Coffee. I have coffee every morning. Most breakfasts I have either oatmeal with scrambled eggs, or I do scrambled eggs with bacon or turkey sausage. I basically eat eggs like almost every single day. I always have lots of protein for breakfast. Oh, I like yogurt too. I do a lot of Greek yogurt with granola. Lots of chicken. We eat lots of chicken. I love roasted vegetables and roasted yams. That's like a go-to thing for me. When all else fails, just go to the supermarket, buy whatever's fresh and looks really good, go home, chop it up, roast it. Like, make two huge things of it, because that is one thing you can reheat. It's healthy, it's quick, it's easy, and it tastes better and better and better every time that you heat it because all the spices melt together. So I would say those things. And wine. I do eat a lot of wine. What is one skincare product you cannot live without? Oh, well, moisturizer, but that's a given. I would say an acid. You like incorporating an acid into my skincare routine changed the game for me. Absolutely got rid of my texture, got rid of my breakouts. I mean, I still get like hormonal breakouts and like if I wear makeup too long and I'm sweating like crazy, I can get a broken out face or whatever, but I would say an acid. I really like the lotion P50 by Biologique Recherche. It's like a combination of lactic and salicylic acid. If you're looking for a more natural alternative, try the acids from Eminence Organics. Cruelty-free, all-natural brand. Really been enjoying that as well. I think I'm going to cut it off here because it looks like I've been talking for like a really long time. And I didn't want it to be too boring because I don't know how interested you guys are in these types of videos, but I like to just chit chat with you guys. I love to share myself here, and if I can share my story and just like make somebody smile or encourage them, that's kind of like my goal at this point is just have fun and share that fun with other people. So if you guys want me to do another Q&A, give this video a like, let me know down in the comments, and we can pull together maybe one where I put makeup on or where I'm cooking in the kitchen or something like that. And we'll throw it all together and just make a huge hodgepodge video or something like that. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for supporting my channel. It truly means the world to me. If you truly want to support me even more, liking a video is, it gives activity to my videos. And I guess that's how YouTube ranks it or something like that. So I hope you guys have a fabulous day, and we'll chat very soon. Bye guys.